The head of the Pontifical Institute for Foreign Missions, or PIME, in the United States, says the Pope's trip to Japan is bringing great joy and confidence to Japanese Catholics. Regional Superior Father Ken Mazur writes in an editorial in the PIME magazine, Mission World, quote, "There is no doubt that this will be a boost for them." Father Ken Mazur joins us now from Detroit. Father, welcome into EWTN News Nightly. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much for having me.
So, Father, you spent more than a decade in Japan serving as a missionary priest. Can you give us some insight to the church there?
Sure. I was there for 13 years, mostly in the Diocese of Yokohama. The Catholic Church is very small, less than one-third of 1%. They take it very personally. It's a very personal relationship that they have with God. And so, you know, most people probably don't even know where we are, where we exist, who we are. Many Japanese in general would know the name of Jesus Christ, but the church is very much an evangelizing church. We try very hard, but we're still in the context of sowing the seeds. It's only been 450 some years since the church was initiated in Japan, and it's a very small church.
Well, like you say, Japanese Catholics are so small, such a small percentage of the population, but they have been very welcoming to the Pope. Can you explain how this trip will be a boost for Catholics and why, in general, this visit is so important?
Certainly. I hear from all of my friends through social media how excited they are that the Pope is coming, because in their daily lives, they may be the only member of their family that's a Catholic. They may be the only person that even knows that they're Catholic. They may not tell others, but they get a chance to see that there are other Catholics around, that there are other people that share their faith. And then the Holy Father, of course, will booster their faith, make them feel very much alive. The Japanese love to get together. They were waving flags and yelling out his name. And it will help their faith and solidify what it is that they believe in.
Because you have spent time in Japan, as you know, two of the most popular religions in Japan are Buddhist and Shinto. Tell us a little bit about those religions.
Well, Shinto is the national religion, but it's more of a philosophy. It might not be quite a religion. And then Buddhism, I would say most of the people would say that they were Buddhist, although Buddhist is not something that you practice in your daily life. You don't go to the Buddhist temple on weekends. You don't. You might go there for New Year's or perhaps the blessing of your car or something like that. But in their daily life, religion is pretty non-existent. Shinto, again, as I said, it's a little bit of religion when you want to get married, and if you have enough money, you might go to the Shinto shrine to get married, to get blessed by one of their priests. But once again, it's not part of their daily life. It doesn't affect.
As I mentioned, you are the regional superior of PIME in the U.S. What exactly is PIME, and where are some of the PIME missionaries in the world?
Sure. PIME is a Society of Apostolic Life. We were founded in Italy in 1850. Europe was having a big mission explosion at that time. The missionaries of Paris, the missionaries of France. And so we were founded as the Italian Missionary Society. We're very similar to Mary Noel, started in 1910, about 60 years after we are. And we work mostly in Asia. That was our original intent, was to go to Asia. We have worked in China, in India, in Thailand, where the Pope also just visited, in Japan, in the Philippines. We also have a few places in Africa, South America as well. We're in 19 different countries around the world. And we're a small society. We have about a little less than 500 people worldwide.
Well, I'm sure our viewers at EWTN will be praying for your missionary work. As Pope Francis has said, it's so important to reach out to the peripheries. Father Ken Mazur, Regional Superior of PIME in the United States, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you very much.